रेडी? ओके।
स्टार्ट।
सो वेलकम एवरीवन टू दिस सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ आवर टैक्सेशन नॉन टैक्सेशन। टुडे एज द स्पीकर वी हैव आवर लविंग सीनियर विश्वजीत भाई। मिस्टर विश्वजीत सेनापति, ही इज फ्रॉम भुवनेश्वर। ही इज हैविंग more than 15 years of industry experience in various domains like embedded systems, telecommunication, and supply chain management, etc. Currently, he is working as the managing consultant in IBM India Software Labs. He has the habit of reading books, traveling to new places, and knowing new people and about their culture too. So, along with him, I think today Smita ma'am is also present, the loving wife of Vishwajit Bhai. So I welcome you both to this session, and to all the participants, thank you so much for making their time out and being present in this session. Over to you, Bhai.
So I think Chinnu, you missed the last part of the introduction. I think he says that something, only one wife in Bhubaneswar, right?
It's on recording, I cannot say about that.
No, I don't know about other cities, but I know in Bhubaneswar. Over to you, Vishajit.
Thank you, Chinnu and Bhai. Thank you for that sweet gesture. Okay. Why Smita? Because all my entrepreneurial ventures are on her names. Nothing on my name. I am just an employee. Still an employee. Okay. So just a disclaimer, nothing, I am doing nothing because it is recorded, that's what I am saying. I am not doing anything. So more awaaz clear hochi and you can see my screen, right? All at least one, two can confirm. Okay,
yes.
Good. Hope it stays like that till another 30-35 minutes. Okay, so I will start with a story, a very small story. Karana, more a story ta gote bahiru padteli. How many of you have read Parable of Pipeline? Anyone? Yes, no?
Yes, I have read that.
Yes.
Good. Yes. Tala story ta koi vaati kona nahi. Anybody who have not read that book?
No.
If I... Okay, no, one no. At least two, three no, then I'll tell the story. Okay, good. Okay, let's go for it. Okay, there are two friends like Biswajit and Satyajit. Okay, so both of them are hardworking and they studied hard. They at that time study means Gurukul kind of thing. Gaare rohutile samane. So both hard study kala pare, they got a job in that village. Nakara job seta bolero thila ki pani ani kina gaare daba. That was a job kind, that kind of thing. No software, nothing like that. So jehetu semane pani ani ki dou thile, then what happened suddenly tankaro gaare jo mati tole jo pani label thila, that got dried up, no water. So semane jo ghore ghore buli kina pani dou thile, that job was at risk. Kon koribe job chali gale tanko ghoro chali bani. So they thought we have to upgrade our skills, maybe I will learn cloud or I'll learn some new technology. So they figured out that seitu 5 km durare jo noi achi se noi re pani bohuchi. So they figured out kemiti se jaga ku jai kina ame pani ani kina asi pariba ga ku au jogei pariba. Obviously they charge more kin kai kina se mane tanko skill upgrade kale. Right, they upgraded their skill to cloud or big data or something, right? So they learned how to go there, bring that water and put it in the village. So everybody was happy that it was going on very nicely. Tanko vitru jone pila thila, A and B, let's say, okay, Mo and Joe. So Mo was not happy with this regular task of doing this same redundant activity. Every day going to the water, bring bucket of water, come back in the evening tired and go back to sleep, then get married, do all the regular things. So he was not very quite happy on about his life. So he was always thinking that can life be different, can there be something. So yeah, I am learning skills, I am smart, I am good, I have a good salary, I am doing fair enough, there is no problem with that, but can I apply my skills for to do something for myself rather than doing for a company? Because one company have hired them to bring water from that place and give it in the village, right? So
तो सी भाविला कि मु कोन करि परि देन व्हाइल थिंकिंग सी भाविला जे मु डेली जाय के ना से जो आणु छी से गोटे गोटे पाइप डेली गोटे गोटे पाइप पके पके आसला रिवर रु फिलेस जेते बळे मो पाइप पकोतला जो कहला कि अरे पागला हे जाय छु 5 किलोमीटर रास्ता अछि तू डेली गोटे गोटे पाइप पके पके जाउ छु कोन करिवे पाइप पके कि ना जस्ट लाफ्ड एंड ही वाज हैप्पी विथ हिज ओन वे आफ्टर 2 इयर्स व्हाट हैपेंड ऑलमोस्ट इट टुक 2 टू 3 इयर्स 5 किलोमीटर दूर रु से जो पाइप सेटअप करथला से थ्रू से जगह रु एपर जों गा पर जों पाइप वाज पे जेते बळे ए जिंसोटा करथला मो ही वाज not aware ki mu kichhi gote nijo pai ka koruchi he just wanted to solve a common man's problem jota gote problem thila aur nijo satisfaction pai ka he started doing something regular irregular than his regular life so what happened next to start the circuit sort then when once that pipeline was built the water started flowing to the village everybody came and the fall in the pit up for more Joe was out of equation because he was redundant. He had only skill of going to the river and getting water. Now Mo wants the pipeline and he is delivering water. So then what he thought? Then he thought ki why can't I scale it up? Mo jodi ei skill ta eti apply kari kina gote gaan ro problem solve kari parli then I can solve over all over India. Why not all over India? Why not outside of India also? So he started distributing coaching that skill itself he how to build a pipeline that skill itself he started teaching and he became an entrepreneur so to start my slides or don't decide to show something I have said something here and there so ya upar ese focus kare dorkar nahi mu and so actually mu टॉपिक दे इसलिए आई सो
यार
वॉइस इज ब्रेकिंग हां ओके लेट मी टेक
व्हाट अबाउट अदर्स
विश्वजीत भाई चिन्नू यो सुनी पर चंदे हां भाई स्लाइड ए उमा मेल आईडी रे फॉरवर्ड कर दियं तो मैं प्रेजेंट कर छे अपन वीडियो ऑफ करके खाली ऑडियो रे ही प्रेजेंट करन मते कहि देबे जोठी स्लाइड फॉरवर्ड करे गथा मैं कर दे ठीक है ओके
ओके एबे मो कथा क्लियर सुबुची कैन आई मूव अ लिटिल बिट और शुड आई वेट
थैंक यू
या इट्स क्लियर
ओके से मझरे मझरे मे बी मोबाइल नेटवर्क फ्लक्चुएट होची सो दैट इज द रीजन बट या लेट्स गो ओके सो द मोरल ऑफ द स्टोरी दैट यस वी शुड हैव ए गुड हेल्दी लुकिंग इनकम ए जॉब इज गुड आई एम स्टिल इन ए जॉब सो नो complain about that and I am very much happy with my job the things that I am doing every day for my company I am very much happy I keep doing that I still love to do coding I still love to do whatever I am doing but the point is how to develop an entrepreneurship mindset when I say so people loko bhavanti ki I am talking about Tata Birla Ambani and blah 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 it is not that actually of course I am not talking about a restaurant owner or a small scale company or a startup a business is something where 500 people are associated with you then only you are termed as a e class person otherwise owning a restaurant or a startup company it is nothing but self employed you own that job it is not a entrepreneur or something like that So how many of us have more than one income recently I was reading a book and there I found this beautiful caption which you can see at the down having two income he is saying having two income is a serious crime I don't know what did he mean by that why did he say that but yeah he says that if you have two income then you are doing a crime actually okay so forget about the job class where we of us rely on one single income and whole our life goes within that income only. Okay, so I'll move on. But the problem with the job class, generally whenever we think about entrepreneurship, I'm sure like mane mu eta real story ko chi back je tole mu Bangalore thili Bagmane tech park pakare one of my friend and me we used to go to have samosa back side mane eta avatar story mu nije ko lagei kina
look like we lost him. Anyone?
Who used to sell samosa like bhai ke chote samosa dukan pe. Hello?
Yeah, so.
Subhash ji.
Ebe asla.
Hello?
Lots of disconnection, Vishwajit, I think.
I am really sorry. I can't help it.
So samosa pat.
We stop the session.
You stop the sharing basically. I move to audio only. Sachin, you please take over the presentation part.
Yes, sir.
Partho, I have sent it to you. Partho, I have sent it to you in WhatsApp. Chinnu, you want me to send it to you?
No, 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 it's okay. If you have sent to one, he can present, no problem.
Oh, okay, okay. Chinnu ko present it.
Okay, forward me.
Yeah, Vishwajit, the samosa part. Let's continue.
Samosa part, yeah.
Yeah, you can continue with the story.
Sorry. Ebe, more awaaz better achi ki than before?
Oh, very yeah. Clear.
Okay, good. You should have done this before. Okay, fine. So, to hella kon ki samosa khaya jau to mo sanga sada bale kahe ki mu bada hale chote samosa dukan kari. To actually mu kahe to sanga pachare au kete bada hobu. Already you are 25. Au kete bada hobu je samosa dukan kari. So what we used to think, ame calculation kortulu je gote samosa ra dam hochi jodi 5 tonga se tol time re thila. यार खर्च केते 2 टंका मैनुअल केते गैस केते खर्च होची ब्ला 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 ऑल कैलकुलेशन इट वाज फिटिंग 2 रुपीस 50 पैसा एंड वी वर थिंकिंग गोटे समोसा रे 2 टंका 50 पैसा लाभ करती दैट वाज आवर माइंडसेट दैट टाइम आ गोटे दिन मु सुनिया को पाइले कि माने समोसा वाला ता छुआ को कोची देख बाबा पाठ पढ़ बड़ होई किना ए माने जेमती जो सार माने आस्तुंदी तांको ओलिया एडी की बड़ बिल्डिंग रे गोटे काम करू सो द Point is, grass on the other side is always green, but it doesn't mean that we are getting an entrepreneurial mindset. There, when we are discussing over our friend circle, ki ame gote company gori, most of this, if I take myself, I think in last 15 years, I have spent at least 12 years thinking about setting up something. I don't know about others, but I believe that 99% software engineers, they do want to do something, but practically we never start anywhere. That is our problem. Who can share the slide now? I just did I get
bhai, give me a few seconds. I'm just opening it. It's downloaded already. Just give me a few seconds.
I need to see it.
Oh, God. Okay.
Hold on.
Is it okay or send it to me? My internet is means its speed is good. Okay.
Is it visible now?
Not yet.
Okay.
Okay. Let me talk about today's agenda. I forgot that I missed that due to this internet connection and other issues. So, agenda is not talking. About any theory, I am not talking what I have thought in my mind or what can be possible or what we should do. I am not a teacher, I am not a preacher, I don't advise anything. That is none of my business. Okay, I am just trying to share my experience with all of us because this is my family. I know Cyber Family. right? So I'm just trying to share mine. If anything you think that you don't like it, please take a supermarket approach. You go to a supermarket, you don't buy everything. Whatever you like, you take that. Whatever you don't like, you dump that. So please dump whatever you don't like from my sharings. Okay, Achinu, can you start the slides? So
that
is a very interesting, go to next, this slide. So most of us, even including me, I always used to think that I want to do something, kuch to karna hai, but what is this? How can I find time? I'm really, really, really very busy. I don't have any time, right? Go to the next slide, please. Okay, so this is a very interesting, a survey done. Next slide, this is not mine. Please pardon me, this is not my data. Some survey which was conducted, which says that, I think it is applicable most to software engineers. You can press F5, if full screen, if you want to make it. F5, okay. So in regular office hours, this is where most of the people's non-productive activities are listed here. Reading news, websites, stocks, some 1 hour, checking social media, discussing non-work related things with coworkers, searching for new jobs. Yeah, this is applicable more to me also. Taking some tea or smoke breaks, right? Making calls to partners, if I have a girlfriend or friend or wife, making hot drinks, tea, coffee, texting, eating snacks, making food in office. All these, if you constitute, I don't know what it comes to, at least 2 to 3 hours we spend every day. Nobody works for 8 hours. I have learned that in past couple of years that smart people, at least after 5 years spending in any industry, you really don't need 8 hours to work. Okay. So there's this nice caption which I read by Stephen Covey. So he says, if you continue to do what you are doing, you will continue to get what you are getting. The very relatable. Okay, next slide. There is a small quiz. I just want answers from you. Next slide, please, Chinna. Yeah. What do you think? Which is the best or the most productive hours of the day? Any answers?
Early morning.
I know 100 out of 100 will come to early morning, isn't it? Or anybody
minus the late night.
Yes. Two answers I was expecting. Early morning and late night.
Whenever I want.
Yeah.
I go for it.
Bhai, you are like me. I. If I would have been asked this question, I would have selected E. Whenever I want. Right. Okay. So. you went to the first slide. Fine. So actually, there is no correct, right, or wrong answer. But yeah, if I. Think about science, scientifically or logically or spiritually or mythologically or our bodies effectiveness wise, then early morning, yes. So they say, means I have read it somewhere, they say that first 3 hours when you get up, it is not like early morning, 5 a.m. or 4 a.m. or 6 a.m. or 7 a.m. The first 3 hours when you get up, that is the most productive hours of our life. Can we all imagine those 3 hours, what we all do? Just take a moment and think what all we do for the first 3 hours after we get up. Mostly non-productive work. We spent the most productive time in very non-productive work, right? There is a caption, unknown, I don't know, so you can read it. Okay. Now, let's take a look at it, a proper person's personal diary, what he does, a millionaire, from his own diary. I have taken it. It's from a book, actually. He has given it. Chinu, next slide, please. When we think that early morning is the best time, when you look at his timetable, his daily routine, next slide. Daily routine, you will understand that, as Bhai said, whenever I want, that is partially correct. But yeah, mind works the first 3 hours after we get up. Can we go to the next slide?
I'm so sorry. My system. Oh, yeah, it's okay.
Okay, yeah, this is the daily routine of a millionaire from his own hands. He wakes up at 10 a.m. I don't think any of us can do that with our current job. He wakes up at 10, freshen up, have some black coffee, then daily rituals, 10:30, affirmations, visualizations. Yeah, those are maybe, if you understand that it's good, right? Goals and tasks for the day. This is very, very important. Then he has a group for which he captures daily tip. 12 p.m. he hits the gym, listen to a book, audio book, and 2 p.m. healthy meal he cooks and eats it while listening to the book. 3 p.m. Shoot a video. His working style was, 3:30, 4 p.m. he was going to a job. He was at a job when he wrote this, okay? So he was not a multimillionaire yet when he adopted this lifestyle. So I was very intrigued with that 4:30 p.m. to 12:30 a.m. How many of us can say that? Even I am not sure. Create magic at work. I was really, really astonished to see this from a person who is interested to quit his job and start his entrepreneurship journey. He's saying that create magic at work from 4:30 p.m. to 12:30 a.m. That means what? The mindset of an entrepreneur is not like job is bad or business is good or something like that. His mindset is whatever I am doing, I am giving my best. So till the time I am associated with my company, I will create magic over there. Then 12:30 a.m. drive back, listening to audiobook. 1 a.m. take interview of internationally successful people. 2 a.m. hit the bed. What is common in all this? Any answers? What do you see repeated in this total schedule? No, nothing repeated. Blank.
Audio book.
Listen to the audio book.
Absolutely. Audio book, right? So there is a quiz question coming forward. That's why I just highlighted that audio book thing. Why he is so enthusiastic to read or listen to books. Yeah. Next slide, please. Here is a reality check, guys. We can, if you can, then you can do it now or you can do it later. Go and open your phone, open your YouTube and just scroll down. YouTube suggests you some videos depending upon your interest, depending upon your last browsing history, blah, blah, blah. We are software engineers. We know what kind of logic or algorithm they play. But the truth is that tells us what kind of mindset we possess currently. The kind of videos that we see, the kind of recommendations that the super duper algorithm gives us in our YouTube, that says to me upfront that this is a reality check. This is the kind of mindset that I am. Samiko, hello?
No, it is from my side. It's okay.
Okay, sorry. Fine. So one thing I talked about, that's the common problem with most of us when we want to go for an entrepreneurial mindset, but we lack is time. We always have a time constraint. But think about the next time when you think about, I don't have time. Think about the two slides where it talks that first 3 hours when we get up, whenever, doesn't matter, 4 a.m., 5 a.m., doesn't matter. First 3 hours and the 8 hour survey that was done. Chinu, next slide, please. The next thing that comes as a hurdle is, what skills? Can I apply my skills? I was talking about Joe and Mo story, right? The guy who learned the skill for his job but applied it for his own business, or he created a enterprise through, by application of that skill on his own way, right? So now the question is, what new skill have I learned in last 6 months? Did I? I don't know, maybe I learned something in my on my job. Definitely, yes. Yeah, we keep learning every day being software engineers. By the way, I just wanted to share these statistics, I forgot. Yeah, we should pat ourselves being a software engineer, because I was reading somewhere that we belong to the, if you have more than 10 years of experience in software industry, then we belong to the top 8%. Guys, top 8% of Indian economy. Top 8%. So don't feel that software engineers are not that great. we are at top 8%. And the reason for that is nothing but a skill that we have acquired through MCA or through job or whatever. We are selling our skill to get our remuneration, whatever we are getting today. So yeah, but the point is, am I learning a new skill every day, every month, or maybe past 6 months? That is a retrospective for you guys. I leave that with. Next slide, please, Chima. Then now the question is, how do I develop my skill? What skill do I need? I don't know where to start. What do I do? I can find out sometime. Yeah, I can manage my time. If I am more than 10 years, yeah, I know how to manage my time. I understand that. I have a family to take care. I have a job, everything. But here is a question, like, how do I upgrade my skills? I showed you that guy, every day he reads almost 2.5 hours of audio book. That means every day he finishes at least one book. Okay. Now, this is another survey was done. What is the average number of books the millionaires in the world read in a year? Any answers? Any wild guess is fine.
15 books.
By choice, nice set of 15.
40.
40. Yeah. Obviously, because that is the highest number, that's why we will go with that. Actually, it is more than 30. Yeah, 30 plus books, a average billionaire. I'm not saying about Mark Zuckerberg or Steve Jobs when he was there. Yeah.
Yes, funny question. Where did you get the data?
internet. This is nothing. Whatever you are seeing here, either from books or from internet, nothing my brain. I don't apply my brains on statistics and gathering data. This is all over internet, all over the books that I read. I'll share a few books which I have read and that has impacted on changed my life. I'll definitely share that. Okay. So yeah, moving on to the next slide. So that is where you should start with. If you want to acquire some skills, you can choose some book as per your interest. But yeah, a book a month, at least a month, is absolutely required. Now, here I have jotted down, this list is actually endless. There's a lot of things which varies from job class to e-class. But yeah, if somebody wants to go through it, yeah, it may give us a pinch in the back. I got a pinch definitely when I read this. But yeah, it is the reality, right? Whenever we think about promoting ourselves or changing our mindset to an entrepreneurship class, we have to take care of this. One is reading books, of course. They read 60 books a year. Generally, if you talk about the high class entrepreneurs, they read 60, that means 5 books a month, right? Obviously, job class, I don't want to take risk. I have my family, I have my home loan, I have my car loan, I have my bike loan, everything. I can't take that risk. But there is a difference that go ahead and take risk. I don't say that I can't take a risk, quit my job and start something tomorrow. But yeah, calculated risk, you have to do take somewhere if you want to promote yourself to the E-class. Obviously, job class always have that fear. I still have that fear. Yeah, Corona. Bhai, band bajana mera. So that fear I always have. If I am an employee, I will continue to live with that fear till the end of my life or till the end of my job. But the E-class, the only fear of not growing, not taking any action. That is their only fear. Job class, they lead a comfortable life. Yes, we are comfortable. I said that. We belong to the 8% of Indian economy. We have a comfortable life, no doubt about it. But yeah, are we satisfied? Then yeah, of course, you won't be in this webinar for sure. If we would have been satisfied, I was telling just before the webinar, maybe 5 people or something. Our hosts are 4 or 5 people. They are bound to join. They are doing a great job. I am really happy, right? And another 5 people I was expecting. But yeah, we have some good people who, good strength who wants to learn E-class, right? Okay, they leave on other people's mercy. I won't explain this, sorry, because I leave on that. I don't think a coach or mentor. This is a very, very important thing. I'll tell a small story about it here. Very small one. Ek bar gote chode sua thila. Okay, one peacock was peacock. No, peacock. No, not peacock. Sua ko English re kong gandhi? Parrot. Okay. One parrot was there. So it was speaking very nicely. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. And Ram Ram, Sita Ram. It was very nice, right? So गोटे पंडित जी आसले ताकु धरले नहीं किना रानी को दे देले ओके पंडित जी ताकु धरले नहीं किना रानी को दे देले महारानी देखो ये हरे कृष्ण कहुची तो सॉरी ही फर्स्ट गेव इट टू ए बिजनेसमैन बिजनेसमैन को घरे देले आपन घरे एक तोता रहइबो बढ़िया बहुत भलो हबो तोता तांका घरे रहले ता पर दिन आसी बिजनेसमैन फेरे देई पड़ला कला की तोता देछु घरे खाली गाली करछु ओके Then next day he gifted it to somebody. Finally, it went to the queen. Okay. Queen next day he called him. Panditji ko dakile. Panditji ko dakile koile. Aaj tote to sarkata hoba. Okay. Then he said, "What happened? Na to tota tu Ramji Ramji koi thulu. Siye ki asi kina pura gali gulos kori kina haran korchi." Then he said, "Your Highness, please give me 10 minutes. Just mo guru ko soito pathai hoba ko chahunchi." Okay, and the 10 minutes diagala, he went back, talked to his guru. Now, the power of mentor, that's what I'm telling. What a mentor can do. Even he was a spiritual guru, he knows everything, he knows how to handle a situation. But when it comes a very crucial situation, when it comes in an entrepreneur's life that he is going through continuous losses, when he continuous backslashing, continuous frustration, continuous from the society, he is getting backslashes from family everywhere. You need someone. And it cannot be a friend. Okay, so when he went back to his mentor or his guru said, okay, I'll handle the situation. Then he went back, then he told Maharani that, Your Highness, you give me just one day, then if the parrot doesn't speak the way you want, then you can take my life itself. Forget his life. You can take both of our lives. So he went to the parrot. Parrot pathuku jaiki ta kanore kale baba kon asuvidha hochi tu to bahare bodhiya ram naam kortilu eti kon hochi parrot kala maharaj mu ram naam kortili akash re udutili ram naam kali boli ka eti asi mate konjure bhar deicho mate gyan diyantu mu kenti free hebi taku gyan dewa chadantu mate gyan diyantu mentor is always a mentor he helps right so he told okay He did the same thing. What would have happened? Next day, Maharani asked, "Oof, yeah, just mori galati baad. Let me just conjure it for the left. Honestly, Pakshi ko, I mean, conjure the Mariva to give me that is our culture." So he opened the case, and parrot fly happily, right? So that is the fine tune. Entrepreneurship journey or even corporate and most of the
voice is getting cut. Bhai, your voice is breaking.
Why my Wi-Fi came back? Now it is better. Okay. Can I go ahead?
It's fine.
Okay, fine, good. Okay, so I was talking about this slide. Yeah, there are a lot of things, family values and all. take some time. If you want to read it, I'm sure you definitely like it. You know, next slide we can go to. Hello? Yeah. This is where most of us actually are stuck because we cannot think about the future. They say it, right? He was a visionary. He had a great vision. It is nothing but our imagination. When we imagine something, then only it comes into existence. Albert Einstein very beautifully said, imagination is more important than knowledge. Yeah, knowledge is required, but imagination is more important. While knowledge defines all we currently know and understand, imagination points to all we might yet discover and create. That is what Albert Einstein said. Okay, next, please. This is where the real fun begins. Yeah, where to start? We talked about the mindset, how to develop it, what to acquire, the skills, the time, the books, and everything. Now the question is, where do I start? You are talking so much, but do you have a tip? Where do I start if I want to start my entrepreneurship journey, or I want to move to that quadrant of life? Okay, these are the few things which you can write today itself. You can start. Okay. Now, I read somewhere that in today's world, if somebody thinks that I need lakhs of money to start a business, then he's the foolish person in the world. Because social media is a great, great, great way to start any kind of business starting tomorrow. Yeah, you need to acquire some skills. We talked about the prerequisites, of course, but definitely you should start creating your own brand in your social media. The way I said, YouTube, when you search the kind of recommended videos, that shows my selfiness, right? That shows what my mindset is. What else can I do? I can create a YouTube channel. I see a lot of our friends and our juniors, they have a YouTube channel of their own. I really appreciate. Don't think that I am starting to go to entrepreneurial journey. So tomorrow onwards, I should have 1 lakh of in extra income. That doesn't happen because I give a very simple equation. I have 10 years of experience, let's say, in software. If I roughly calculate, I would be earning 15 to 30 lakhs. That's the maximum that I can earn in India if you are not working for Google type of company. If we try to understand that 50 after 10 years of investment, who did the investment? Company. Every year they are paying me at least 3 to 5 lakhs. Till I reach that 15 lakhs or 30 lakhs bracket, right? Every year company invested in me. I did the job. I sold my skills. I gave 8 hours every day, 8 to 10 hours. Then after that, I started earning 1 lakh rupees after 10 years of my career, right? How much of money got invested? How much money company invested? So don't expect that tomorrow I'll start my entrepreneurship journey and start earning money right away. That doesn't happen. It takes time, but baby steps has to be taken whenever and wherever possible, right? Affiliate marketing, I don't know if we have heard it, but yeah, most generally what the job people say that I hate selling. Guys, I read it somewhere again. If you hate selling, then you can never influence your kids at home. If you cannot sell your idea to your to anybody else, forget selling your idea to your kids. What do I mean by selling my idea to my kids? When I say that, guys, you should not watch TV now. I'm selling my idea to them. If I am not a good salesman, my kids won't listen to me. Right? Affiliate marketing is nothing but Amazon affiliate. You can try. You can go Google it and do. What I'm saying is that how you can start today itself. Right? You can start your own business. Network marketing, yeah, there are multiple options. I don't know. I won't recommend anything is good or bad. I am not here to analyze that. But yeah, that is an option which you can start today itself, tomorrow itself. Don't worry that whether it is a MLM, this, that. Doesn't matter. I want to go move. That's all. Online coaching and tuitions. We all are skilled here. Whoever is there, they know how to present. They know how to teach a skill or something else. I want to start, I'll start somewhere. I'll in maybe next couple of slides more, I'll share my ventures, whatever I am doing right now. This is part of that. Become a cab owner. I read it somewhere. Ola cab owner. It's very easy to become. But yeah, it's an entrepreneurial journey you are starting. You will have risks, yeah, definitely. Every business will have, but it's a calculated risk. When we talked about calculated risk, 5 lakhs, 6 lakhs, 7 lakhs, depends how much I want to take risk or how much I can. Be a copywriter. There are multiple openings if you have writing skills, if you can learn skills, video editing, copywriting, image, blah, blah, content writing. Everything is there. This is not just to get another job or get some extra income. This is to learn new skills or learn to know your potential, know my potential. Where can I build my journey? Right? Learn new skills, must read books. There is no other way than reading books. Yeah, I'll again make it very clear. I'm not talking here about opening a restaurant or opening a shop or opening a startup. I'm talking about a business which can potentially be termed as a business when it has 500 plus employees. Okay. Now, this is a very nice caption I read somewhere. You can either have excuses or success. You cannot have both. Next slide, please. Yeah, Ajay said, these are few books which I read. I have a mini library. I have some 200 odd books. But these are few books. If you really want to start changing your mindset, the first one, 80% mindset, 20% skills, at least 50% the content that you see in this slide goes credit to Lev Gavi, is the Indian. He has created a new, completely new phenomena of entrepreneurship. He calls it passionpreneur. He is the India's first passionpreneur. If you want to read, this is the best book to start with, 80% mindset and 20% skill. Few other books are there. Rich Dad Poor Dad, definite must for everyone, by Robert Kiyosaki. Think and Grow Rich by Napoleon Hill, that is one of my favorite. And the last one, which I read last week, maybe, yeah. This 6 Sundays a Week Life by Dev Gavi. I was so impressed by his first book, I immediately purchased the second book. Yeah, they say book is the mirror of our life. There is no doubt about it. Yeah, I think we are at the end. Go to the last slide, please. You know? No, you came back, I guess. Next. Yeah, it is no heading because it is... this is what I currently am associated with. I have a full-time job, as we all know. All the rest of the things, nothing on my name. It's all everything on my wife's name. That's why she is there on this workshop, on this webinar. Thank you guys for allowing her to join this. Okay, yeah, she is the director in BSS Free Enterprise Private Limited. He has her own farm after doing this. There is a nice story to this proprietorship farm. I'll share that after I go through. Yeah, I do some coaching, math, science, and Java, basically to school students, because I don't have a brand right now to go and teach anywhere, but I do that. Yes, we do some insurance advisory for health insurance and general insurance. We do some network marketing. Definitely, that is where I started my journey, guys. That was the, I would say, I may not have earned money there, but I earned a lot of experience there. I earned everything that I, knowledge-wise, it made me read books. That is where I started my journey maybe 3-4 years back. Social media, I have a presence, yeah, Free Brain Quiz Series. Few of you may know. Yeah, tomorrow there is a quiz. If anybody wants to participate, their kids or you want to participate, the link is Creative Brain Development. And I have something in pipeline which... this year I could not launch because of the corona and all. Maybe next year, creativebrain.in. If you feel like, go and please visit and you may know more than that. Yeah, as I said, books are mirror of life. I think I can write some books, so I am writing 2 books. Why 2 books? There is no logic. I get bored with one thing. That's why I thought I'll start 2. Whenever I get bored with one, I start switch to the other one. So yeah. I think that one will come in Jan 2021. I may need your blessings for that. Yeah, these are the few things which are I am currently associated with, and I love to associate with more. I said that I'll tell you about the story, right? That of Topiocracy Farm. I was here in Odisha like for 1 year. That first venture which I started, BSS3, that took me 1.5 years. 1.5 years time just to start a full-time business. Of course, I mean, for me part-time, but yeah, a complete wholesale company. To start that, it took me 1.5 years. But after that, whatever you see after that, those have come in last 6 to 8 months, I would say. Everything after that, except the network marketing thing, which was prior to everything. But yeah, everything else after BSS3, that came in last 8 months, I would say, 8 to 10 months max. Okay, how SBS Trading Corporation happened, I won't name, but yeah, there was a friend of mine who used to study with me in Revenza College. We were good friends, but yeah, not close like I have with you guys. My cyber family, I care for them, I share with them, I love to be with them, right? Not like that, but yeah, was a good friend. After I came back here, he was watching me from outside. He was seeing that I'm doing this, I'm doing that. And he had a proposal for me without any investment. Guys, it's a proprietary farm. To open that farm, at least you need 20 lakhs of investment. And he shared me a proposal. I can't share it now. But yeah, he shared me a proposal with zero investment. And that is already started from past 3 months at least. And couple of consignments have gone to that farm itself. Okay, and that is sole farm, because proprietorship, you know, that is a sole farm, no partner, no nothing, right? So what I want to say and wrap it up here is that when you start your journey, when you think of starting your journey to the entrepreneurship side, as soon as you jump into anything, the pipeline will completely flow. See, remember that story, Joe and Mo. Imagine once after he built that pipeline, in the other side, whether he sends water or he sends milk, it will flow through, because he built that pipeline with 2 years of effort, 2 to 3 years of effort. And Warren Buffett, a very renowned person, he says that to any business to settle down, it requires at least 1,000 days. So you should give yourself at least 1,000 days before you start questioning yourself whether I'm an entrepreneur or not. Like, but to build the mindset, you can do it right away, today, tonight. And you can start your business tonight. Yeah, that's all I think I had to share. Thank you for patiently listening to me. And I'm really extremely sorry for all the hiccups that happened during this. So I was not mentally prepared that if the Wi-Fi will go down. Yeah, anything anybody wants to share or ask?
So Biswajit, what is that SBS one, the second one?
That's a farm which it's a trading company, basically from company to the end distributor and the middleman kind of thing.
No, what kind of trading?
Bleaching powder.
Okay. No, it does not matter, because small
thing. Yeah,
it
doesn't matter. Yeah, very small thing. It's just a single product, but one consignment is like 8 to 10 lakhs, so one truck, kind of that kind of thing.
Yeah, I would just want to ask you, what is that trading when you write trading corporation? Yeah.
The name or something I wanted to give, BSS, Biswajit Smita and Biswajit Smita. So that way it goes BSS and SBS like that.
Why should I stop presenting now?
Yes, please.
People mostly say if you are multitasking, your performance will be low, right? So you are doing multiple tasks. So how could you successfully manage those tasks?
Well, actually, that is what I have learned so far. That when I read that statement, two income is a crime. It just because I was on that path. So that is why I understood that no entrepreneur think on single line of income. And if you have to do multiple things, you have to manage it properly. See, I'll tell you how it is it possible. Because the context switching matters. when if you can do the context switching properly, everything will fall in place. What do I mean by context switching? I'm writing something and I get a call from my farm DSS3, let's say, sir, this payment, this check has bounced. Can you switch the context immediately? That is where most of the people fail, because if you have three things in mind, nothing goes parallel. You cannot handle three things in parallel. It is all sequential. So how do you manage? If I talk about in machine language, it is all about context switching. If you can do that, then everything falls in place. And when you start doing that, you have to delegate a lot of things. You cannot own everything. I don't own, except for accounts, I don't do anything in BSS2. SBS, except for calling, except for receiving calls, except for managing the calls, I don't do anything for SBS training. Coaching, that's my passion. I am going to build my career in that. That is where I do personally invest my time and everything there. Insurance advisory, I don't do anything there, because I have a person who makes the cold calls and get me deals. I give him some payment and he is happy. I am just having another side income from there. So I don't do anything there. Network marketing, I have invested a hell lot of time. I totally agree with that. I did not get the return that I may have expected. But yeah, I learned a lot of things. These things, social media and this creative brain, it is coming up by, it is still in a budding stage. Three brain quiz series is something which I am giving back to the society. Tomorrow there is a quiz where I'm giving prizes also, some Amazon gift coupon or something. Yeah, when you have a passion for something like this free brain quiz or creative brain and coaching, these two, why you won't feel tired. That doesn't come under any umbrella or any purview. You tell me at night 1 a.m. to write a quiz question or become make a question set, I'll get up and do that. So that is different. That is something about passion. But yeah, multitasking, you have to delegate. Right? You cannot own everything and do it. That is not practically possible. No entrepreneur does that.
Okay, so I think somewhere in the middle you have mentioned that money is not, for example, someone says give me 10 lakh, I will start a farm or something, but that is not necessary. So is that true actually? Because money is important. People are doing business and finding some other investor or something to improve their business. So how important is money really?
Okay, I heard it from a businessman itself. I was discussing a proposal with him and I did not have money. It required some 1 crore of investment. That did not work out. That is for separate reason. But when I was talking to him, he said me, Biswajit, try to understand this thing. And he's a Odia guy. Okay, he told me, try to understand this thing. Whenever a business comes into picture, money is at 17th position. 17th. There are 16 other parameters which you have to fulfill, then money will automatically come. But I'll give you example of BSS3. We started with 15 lakhs, three partners, 15 lakhs. Now it is 1 crore company. Who can be? I ran it for 1 year. The bank where I had the CC account, they only gave me 80 lakhs. So money is a criteria, but not a great criteria. If I want to do something, then money is not a showstopper.
Okay, so if you allow me, I'm taking a pause in between to announce something. Just a general announcement. From next month onwards, we will have 2 sessions in a month. The second and fourth Saturday of each month from October, we will start. And for now, we have completed almost 1 hour. So I request Biswabhai, can you ask if Smita Bhojo is ready to share something about her initiatives and all? Hello, Vishwin Bhai?
Okay.
Yeah, so, I'm trying to get hold of her, but looks like
she's. No, tired. If she's comfortable, she can do it, or else.
Oh, okay, one thing we can do, whether Smita is on the line.
From a line also? Yeah, she is there on the line.
Okay, chikaj. So let me ask one question to Smita, if she's okay.
ए होल्ड ऑन होल्ड ऑन बिश्वेत भाई आपन को इंट्रोड्यूस करा पड़े भाउजन को
हेलो
चल बने डायरेक्ट क्वेश्चन हो बने
हाय
वेलकम भाउज
Hi Smita.
Hi.
Smita, can you hear me? Smita, suna rahe ho? Ji.
Yeah, yeah.
Theek hai. Smita, let me ask one question. So how has being an entrepreneur affected your family life?
ଆମେ
ଜାଣିଛୁ ସେ ଆକ୍ଟିଭ ପିଲାଟା ତ
ଆକ୍ଚୁଆଲି ସେମିତିରେ ବି ମାନେ ଅଫିସ ପରେ ସିଏ ମାନେ ୱାନ୍ ଆୱାର ଖଣ୍ଡେ ଘରେ ରହିକିନା ସେ ତାଙ୍କର ଖଟି ଟାଇମଟା ଚାଲିଥିଲା ତ ସେ ସେଇ ଟାଇମରେ ଫାଷ୍ଟ ଟ୍ୟୁସନ ଗୋଟେ ଷ୍ଟାର୍ଟ କଲେ ତାପରେ ଏବେ ଅନଲାଇନ୍ ତ ଚାଲିଛି ଆଉ ଡେଲି ୱାନ୍ ଆୱାର ସେମିତି ଆଉ ମାନେ ବେଶୀ ଟାଇମ ତ ନାହିଁ ଡେଲି ୱାନ୍ ଆୱାର କେବେ କେବେ ନାହିଁ
ଗୁଡ୍ ଗୁଡ୍ ଆମେ ତ ବହୁତ ଖୁସି ଦେଖିକି ବିଶ୍ୱଜିତ ବହୁତ ଗ୍ରୋ କରୁଛି ଆମର ତ ସବୁବେଳେ ବେଷ୍ଟ
ୱିଶେସ୍ ବହୁତ ଟାଇମ ବି ମାନେ ଦଉଛନ୍ତି ନିଜକୁ ମାନେ ରାତିରେ କେବେ କେବେ କୁଇଜ ପାଇଁ ମାନେ ଗୋଟେ ରାତିରେ କରିକି ବୁକ୍ସ ବି ଲେଖୁଛନ୍ତି ଆଉ ଡେଲି 6:30 ରେ ଉଠିକିନା ବହି ପଢା ହଉଛି ତାପରେ ଆମେ ଆମର ଅଲଗା ଟାଇମ ସିଏ ତାଙ୍କର ସେଇ ଟାଇମରେ ପଢାପଢି କରୁଛୁ
ଓକେ ଓକେ good 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 Biswajit
ha bhai
ha partho kon kahuchu kre oh thik ache ओके ठीक अच्छे सो गाइज समस्ते जो माने भी एबे अच्छो प्लीज ऑन योर वीडियो फॉर ए 30 सेकंड्स सो एवरीबॉडी सो जे ऑन न करिवो ऑन नकला जाय त ना डाकियो पड़िवो ओके आई विल वेट फॉर एट लीस्ट 20 सेकंड्स 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8
Where are you, Mithibai?
10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. अच्छा चिनु के ऑन करने आओ कहलो संगीता ऑन कला
अपन निजे ही ऑन कर
अरे मो वीडियो नहीं मुझे जॉइन करछि भाई कौन करिवे पुअर मैन सो आई एम नॉट ए नॉट एन एंटरप्रेन्योर लाइक विश्वजीत सर
हां मैन बैक कैमरा ऑन फेस टू गो ओके आई एम कैप्चरिंग इट या डन
ए 1 मिनट वेट वेट विश्वजीत स्मिता को नहीं क्या पखुगु दैट इज वेरी बैड मैन
ए हां सब तो
सॉरी अरे फिर गोटे स्नैप लेवे कर
अरे एवरीबॉडी ऑन करो कैमरा रेडी के
आई सी नव भाई सिद्धार्थ भाई विभू प्रसाद दास संगीता
Yeah.
please make sure my photo is coming. Vishal bhai, last question for you, if you don't mind. Okay, so what gives you that energy, that enthusiasm? What is the energy booster in you? What is that thing?
That's a very, very, very difficult question. But
well, genuine, you have to say it genuinely. I know some of the boosters.
See, I'll tell you. Frankly speaking, I never had that enthusiasm to run into this separate line. Like every software engineer, I was also daydreaming. Every Friday, I used to think I'll do this thing. You ask my wife, she'll tell you. I would have planned for at least 50 businesses in Bangalore itself when I was there. But I did nothing about it. Where did I get that inspiration? Something. That is why I keep repeatedly saying that network marketing, when I started, they insisted on reading books. That is the only takeaway which I took from there. And when I started reading books, I tell you, you take this book, man. I'm telling you. You take this book, 80% mindset and 20% skills. You read this book. If you can sleep at night, then I'll say that you don't have a spine behind your back. I am guaranteeing you, giving you guarantee you read this book. So this book keeps me moving. And when I started writing my own book, obviously you can't sleep, man. That is the obvious thing. That's a passion thing. You cannot stop it. Okay, to one line and one word answer, yes, books. That gives me that energy.
Okay, so do we have any other questions or anything? Any
technical doubt is in a panel, but you know, over, you know.
Vishwajit, tell me one thing.
Wait.
So, what are some of the traits you feel to be an entrepreneur? Like somebody whether can do or if somebody will start and really will succeed. So what do you feel some of the key traits? Maybe if you'll ask some of the key three key traits of an entrepreneur. So what you would say this?
Right. First thing is that you have to have a desire within. Jaddi manna bhitar nahi. When I said that, I laughingly on a joking note, I said that I would have started 50 businesses in Bangalore and nothing I started. That mindset was there. That desire was there. That is the first thing. For definite sure. If you don't have a desire, you read this book. I'm telling you, you won't get sleep for two nights. But after that, you will go back to normal, regular thing. That is the first thing, desire. And second thing, if you read...
So that is yes. The one book you suggested, that is some four-hour workbook that Timothy Ferris. He also, I don't remember, something said same thing like, no, you should have the burning desire to do it. I don't know where that burns, but
so it's not a burning desire. It will not burn overnight, bhai. Eta lagi pura bidi holiya mane dhire 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 jalu thibo jodi taku daily tel na pakela se ko dino bujhi jibo janai padiba. That is why I said it is a 2 to 3 years work.